So you guys are open for public, like do people need an appointment or can they just show up? What's the situation up on the mountain?
Yeah, thanks for asking. It is only by appointment, and because we have to be. I mean, we're regulated by Napa County supervisors, winery definition ordinance, blah, blah, blah. But we are open 7 days a week, so we do require appointments ahead of time. But what we're able to do, because we have such a unique place to visit, is we've got a lot of different experiences. So, you know, you can come up, just walk through the door, get a cheese plate and a little tour in the winery. That's great for the first time guests, you know, that haven't been there. That's a great place to start.
I was a first timer. Right.
So
I don't know.
So, you know, we have were you in the wood paneled room, the library?
As a matter of fact, I did see the library.
Okay. So that's a nice place to visit. We also have a balcony, nice weather. You can kind of sit out on the balcony and it looks all the way down into the Napa Valley.
It's extraordinary.
And we also have a villa on property that Fred built back in the 70s. We call Villa Valentine. And the villa is this amazing little stone villa. Can I say that again?
Villa. Right. Stone villa.
But it's perched just looking, you know, this amazing view. And we have...
breathtaking.
So we have the ability to take people around on a Polaris ATV, six-seater ATV. So you buckle up and kind of tour the property through the orchards, the vineyards, by the springs, and then end up down at the villa for a pretty amazing private little tasting down there.
That's pretty
which,
cool.
Yeah, I mean, to really experience what it's like to experience Spring Mountain. I mean, it's one of the best experiences on the mountain for sure.
I've got two more quick questions if I can, Matt.
Yeah.
You know, I missed the first part of the. Sure, but are you making something else for white wine aside from Riesling? And is the Riesling from Spring Mountain as well?
The Riesling is from our estate on Spring Mountain. Okay. And so that's the only estate white wine that we produce. We do source some Sauvignon Blanc from down on the valley floor in Oakville and Yountville, and we do a Sauvignon Blanc as well.
Okay.
But the Riesling is our estate white wine.
Okay, and last question. So I heard that you... you hired my friend Autumn for the last harvest. How did she do? Should I be scared about the 2011 Terra Valentine? Are they safe to drink?
Let me answer this question for you.
Yeah, sure.
That topic came up earlier today.
Oh, okay.
They hired an intern. They now have an employee.
Yeah. Autumn is sticking around. She's great. I've known Autumn for a long time. So, you know, for me, we are such a tight-knit group up there. And so, it's really important for me to get people on board that can relate to the employees. Hard worker. And Autumn's been great. She did a great job.
Howdy. You think so? She used to work with Matt and I at Dina De Luca.
Really? Not only she's strikingly attractive.
Yeah, but she's married. And you are too.
Work ethic of... a ferocious wolf.
Yeah.
But the beauty of a fox.
I have a non-wine related question for you or comment.
Oh boy. Everyone, welcome Lance. Lance,
keep it clean.
Hello, everybody.
ABR.
So I'm also a St. Helena resident and also recently held a big event in St. Helena, and I know Terra Valentine is very well active in the community, particularly St. Helena. And Sam and Terra Valentine and Tracy also, who works there, and a dear friend of mine, made a very generous contribution to our Celebrate St. Helena event Saturday night, which was an auction benefiting the Downtown Renaissance program. So I just wanted to give a little thank you and a shout out to you guys and Terra Valentine for supporting St. Helena and the beautiful community that it is.
Lance, this one's for you. Attaboy. Good job.
Yeah. Thank you. That's
you're welcome. That's the beauty of the wine business is our, you know, it's so easy for us to help out in the entire country. I mean, we donate stays at that villa that I've been describing.
Really?
We donate stays to the village auctions all around the country.
Do you donate those to the Simpson Fund?
Yeah, it's so far. You know, you have to buy a little more wine than that. But
I started off with 6-pack today.
Well, we have our club destination, which is your ability to.
Lovely
buy.
Susan coming back in with a Twitter
I
question.
I feel like an easy reader.
Yeah, so bring the thunder, baby.
So this is from Brian. It's a Twitter question, and he says, "Sorry if I'm late to the party, but what's the overall production of each wine?"
Okay, good question.
Excellent question, Brian. Thank you for tweeting in.
So, you know, overall production at Terra Valentine is we're about 8,000 to 10,000 cases, depending on our yield. Since we're in a state, you know, it's a little bit variable. The Riesling, we produce about 200-300 cases of that. The Amore is around 400 to 500 cases. The Yverdon Vineyard fluctuates. Typically, it's around 300 to 500 cases of that. And then the Marriage is also around 500 to 600 cases. So these are, you know, some of our more, you know, limited productions. We also produce a Spring Mountain Cab, which is kind of our wine that you see more in the broad market. It's, you know, it's nationally, we're in 40-something states with that wine, and it's still an estate wine, but it's a blend of the two estates that we've got.
Oh, that's cool.
It's a great cab. I mean, it's a $45 cab from estate cab from Spring Mountain. It's a hell of a deal, that wine, yeah.